Hi, I'm Peter Travers, movie critic for Rolling Stone, and I'm here to tell you about the movie. I mean, there's only one movie really this weekend that you need to see, and it is Quentin Tarantino's Inglourious Basterds, the title that needs a spell check. I'm not going to spell it, but you'll see it, and you'll see there's an extra O or U, or Bastards is T-E-R-D-S. What is that about? You know what it's about is that Quentin was inspired by a 1978 Italian movie called Inglourious Basterds, spelled correctly, and he's basically lifting the title, so the only way to lift it is to spell it differently. So mystery solved. All right, what is it? You've seen the trailer all the time with Brad Pitt saying to his men, who are all Jews, he's not. He's a Tennessee cracker. He's got the hillbilly voice, who's part Cherokee. And he's telling these guys who are all tough Jews and GIs that they need to get 100 Nazi scalps. It's always Nazis. It's not Nazis. It's Nazis. Because Brad Pitt is just doing that. He's got his jaw jutted out.
Every man under my command owes me 100 Nazi scalps. And I want my scalps.
Get those scalps. And it's a revenge movie. It's a revenge movie with about 50 subplots in it. It's got tons of talk. And look at you people. Tarantino has always got a shitload of talk. Don't tell me, oh, it's too talky, it's 2.5 hours long. It's got subtitles. People are speaking in French and in German and Italian. Live with it. Live with it. You know, we've had enough of Transformers, haven't we, and G.I. Joe, where they do this crap. Live with somebody that actually has an imagination. I'm going to say this is World War II the way Quentin Tarantino sees it, which, of course, is not the way it happened. One of the subplots in this involves a young French girl who escapes the Nazis and runs away to Paris. And in a few years, in 1944, she's running a theater there that looks like Cinema Paradiso. Her idea is to get every Nazi in the world, the whole elite, Goebbels, Hitler himself, to sit in and watch a movie and burn them all up as if they would be in a concentration camp. Did this ever happen? No way! It happens in Quentin Tarantino's mind. Just like I said about Brad Pitt, there weren't these Jewish soldiers who did all this and took scalps. Quentin wants to do it. And you know what? It's the power of cinema to do it. That's who's on his side. He knows this can happen, and his dialogue is so rich. You know, in fact, I interviewed him recently for my ABC Popcorn show, and Quentin himself, nobody can speak better about what he does with his own language. So let's listen to him for just a minute.
There is a quality to my dialogue where it's kind of poetry, but kind of not, but kind of. You know, it's not poetry, but kind of. It's not music, but kind of. All right? It's not rap, but kind of. It's not a stand-up monologue, but kind of. You know, it's all those together. And it really, you have to have a comfortability with the language and get the music in it and get the rhythms in it.
And I want to say something more than what Quentin is saying. Performances in this movie across the board are really intriguing. I love the idea that Michael Fassbender, the guy who was in Hunger, plays a British officer whose job before that was movie critic. And he's a hero. He's an actual World War II hero. What other movie has a movie critic as a hero? Only Quentin Tarantino, who worked in a video store and reviews movies if you stop him on the street, would do this. But the real performance in this movie, and the one that I think will be nominated for an Academy Award and even win an Academy Award, is an Austrian actor named Christoph Waltz. He is Hans Landa, the chief Nazi. He speaks in every language that could be known and is so good that you can hear him actually thinking in four languages. I don't know how this happened. You cannot take your eyes off of this guy, or the images, or the way Tarantino uses music. And he borrows it from other movies, sure. Ennio Morricone, Once Upon a Time in the West. This is all what Quentin Tarantino lives and breathes. So sure, there are faults in the movie. You know what? I don't care about the faults, because this is a guy that lives and breathes cinema, and so should you if you pretend to like movies. All right, Quentin Tarantino, Inglourious Basterds is the one, but it's scum bucket time. Now there's two comedies that I actually had to sit through. I had to go through the horror of them. One of them is called My One and Only, in which Renee Zellweger plays the mother of the actor George Hamilton, who you've seen on Dancing with the Stars, or in movies maybe you've forgotten, but Zorro the Gay Blade. And it's about him as a young boy traveling across America with his mother, with Renee Zellweger doing the worst Southern accent I have ever heard in any movie ever.
I could probably teach you a lot of things, child.
And the other comedy is called Post Grad with Alexis Bledel, who you know from Gilmore Girls, and she plays a graduate student, of course she's out of school, who gets a job in publishing and quits in this era, quits her job in publishing. So these two are going straight in the scum bucket, and we all know who controls that scum bucket now, Transformers 2. So the Autobots and the Decepticons, when these two movies come in, I want you to gobble them up. I want them to be caught in the crossfire. Destroy them. I'm Peter Travers.